I'm in Kissimmee, Florida, on my way to meet with a woman who claims that she had an encounter with an alien life form. She was truly terrified. She says this thing was in her backyard. Jalen Hynek defined this as a close encounter of the third kind.
In order to classify sightings, Project Blue Book investigator Dr. Hynek developed an identification scale. Simply getting close to an unidentified object is a close encounter of the first kind. If the unidentified object left physical evidence, such as scorched earth or impressions on the ground, it is a close encounter of the second kind. The top of the scale is an encounter with an actual entity, known as a close encounter of the third kind. One woman claims to have recently experienced this type of rare encounter in southern Florida.
Today, I'm gonna meet with Trish Bishop. She agreed to meet me in the backyard where she said her encounter happened. Hi, Trish.
Hey, I'm nice
Ben.
To meet you.
You too.
Hi.
Thank you so much for meeting me here. So you lived over in this house in this direction over here.
That's correct.
How long did you live there for?
Since February of 2013 to July of 2019.
And this event happened when?
February 28th of 2013.
So take me back to what was the first thing that you noticed that was unusual about your property, what was going on?
It was a Thursday afternoon. And I get home from work, and I go out on the back porch just to relax. I had seen what appeared to be this wavy thing. It was above the trees. It was about 10 to 12 feet in length, and it just sounded like something was walking over there by the edge of the woods.
Something large?
Yeah. And I'm sitting there, and I'm like, what in the world is that? I'm not thinking alien. I'm not thinking any of that. That's not going through my head. And all of a sudden, I can see him. This thing was a human body, 6'2", 6'3", very, very well built, military type body. But he had a creature's head. And he had these massive, very pronounced jaw bones. When I saw his eyes, I thought, that can't possibly be his eyes because he can't close them. There's no way to close them. And I thought, if he knows I can see him, he's gonna kill me.
Because of the look, stature, and height of the alien being, Trish felt threatened immediately. She created a digital sketch of what she saw.
I created something off the internet.
Oh,
and
my
this
gosh.
This is really close.
Trish, this would be terrifying.
And I'm like, he's gonna kill me. So I thought, if I pretend that I don't see him, then I might be safe. So I just kept playing with my phone, you know, and he just stared at me, and then he turned around, and he looked into the woods again. And turned back around, he took a couple more steps. All I kept thinking was, if I dial 911 and the police show up and they see all those cops and everything coming here, he's gonna annihilate us. So he takes about 5 or 6, 7 steps forward towards that wavy thing. When he enters that wavy thing, everything disappears. So what I did was I sat there for a couple minutes. After a couple minutes, I got up. I wanted to see if I could see that UFO. Couldn't see it. I couldn't see it anywhere.
Did you tell anybody about this after the event?
No. I didn't tell anybody for 4 years. I work with government contractors. I have a clearance. It's not something that you just go out and tell people, oh, I saw an alien. I could possibly lose my job.
Though Trish stayed silent for years, she never forgot the encounter in her backyard. Eventually, she came across the Mutual UFO Network, or MUFON, online. Their specialty, deciphering UFO sightings.
So it also had a link to report. Uh-huh. And I thought, I'm gonna tell. I know what I saw. I don't have to justify anything to anybody. I got an email back from John Gagnon with MUFON, and he started talking to me, and he came out here. We did a walk through the woods and everything. I showed him where I saw the alien. So he walked around with me and everything, and he said, why don't you get a hunting tracker? And I did. I bought one.
Trish installed a hunting tracker, a motion-triggered camera used to track game in her backyard, aimed at where she had seen the alien. A few weeks later, it captured something shocking.
I did get a really good photo of a UFO.
Really?
And I can show you a picture of that.
I would love to see that, please.
Trish's trail cam was triggered to take this photo after detecting rapid motion. The UFO appears to be streaking away at a near-perfect vertical ascent. Photo analysis conducted by MUFON concluded that this object was 27 feet wide and 12 to 13 feet long, with no visible means of propulsion. Other UFOs sighted in American airspace have behaved similarly, namely the Tic Tac craft that was filmed by U.S. Navy pilots in 2004. The Tic Tac was reported to hover in space almost unnaturally before taking off in whatever direction it pleased at near supersonic speeds.
What part of the sky did you take this with? I mean, where was your trail cam pointed in relation to the sky here?
This trail cam was on the crepe myrtle tree where I saw the alien.
Okay.
And it was pointed west towards Kennedy Space Center.
Well, Trish, you've given me a lot of great information. I can tell this was a very impactful event for you, and I appreciate you taking me back.
Trish's story is incredible. Could Trish have witnessed a UFO and its pilot?
So the firsthand witness testimony is crucial, but I also like to get a balance from an investigator's point of view. So I want to talk to John, and hopefully he can fill me on what he did here.
John Gagnon is the chief MUFON investigator for Florida. Over the course of his career, his job has been to separate fact from fiction in sightings all over the state. If Trish's sightings ring authentic, John will know.
So, John, could you tell me, when did you first interact with Trish?
I was the chief investigator for MUFON, and so all reports come to me for Florida. Trish submitted a sighting report. And I started reading the report, and the first line was, you're not going to believe this, but I saw an invisible spaceship. And I'm thinking, oh boy, here we go.
Yeah, you probably get a lot of that, right? And you're thinking,
we get enough of it, yeah. I started reading, something just got my attention. I started reading the actual report, and I'm thinking, I've got to get in touch with this lady.
What was it about the report that really caught your attention?
It sounded very sincere. It wasn't rambling like most of those type reports are.
And was she pretty detailed in the account?
She was.
John was impressed by Trish's account, but he was also impressed by her background. If she was fabricating the sighting, she was putting a lot on the line.
For the majority of her life, she'd been a security specialist working for government contractors. She had a top secret security clearance. When I found out what her background was, it's like, okay, this lady's not sitting here lying.
Like, she had nothing to gain by making up a story.
Exactly. I drove a little over an hour to where she lived at the time. We talked for quite a while. We walked down in the woods when she told me what she saw. I took pictures.
John's takeaway was the same as Ben's. Trish was a highly credible witness with a lot to lose who encountered something extremely threatening.
Well, with all that you've done and people, witnesses that you've talked to, where does this case rank as far as credibility?
It's probably one of the top three. We looked at a photo that she had taken.
Was this from the trail cam?
Yes, this was from the trail cam. As it turned out, there had been a sighting about 6 months earlier by somebody else, 11 miles away.
And you think it's the same object?
I would say there's definitely a possibility.